human rights are women's rights, and women's rights are...
Phenomenal woman. That's my mother and all your mother.
Women used to the very best of their ability.
Both men and women should feel free to be strong.
Woman's place is truly wherever she wants it to be.
This is Forgotten Voices, a women's history series. Ever wonder what a girl with a limited education, raised in poverty and racial violence can accomplish? Well, if she dedicates her life to ending those cycles, she can make history. One such woman to do just that was Daisy Gadsden Bates. Daisy was born in 1914 in Arkansas. When just a toddler, her mother was raped and murdered by three white men, and her father fled the area, fearing for his safety. She was raised by friends of the family. When she was 27, Bates and her new husband started their own newspaper, the Arkansas State Press. The paper served as a voice for the civil rights movement. It featured stories of police brutality against black citizens and served as a champion for black veterans of World War II. In 1952, Bates became president of the NAACP's Arkansas branch. She'd later go on to play a pivotal role in ending segregation in Arkansas schools. In fact, her home served as the de facto command post for a group of students known as the Little Rock Nine. Although Bates helped the students gain entry into the all-white high school, she'd pay the price personally. Crosses were burned on her lawn, and businesses pulled their advertising from her newspaper. 2 years later, Bates and her husband were forced to quit publishing the paper. Bates would go on to work in Washington, D.C. for both the Democratic National Committee and on anti-poverty projects for the Johnson administration. But a stroke put an end to her time in the nation's capital, and she returned to her home state. Despite her health, she briefly revived her beloved newspaper and continued to fight for civil rights in the South. Bates is also credited as the only woman asked to speak at the famed March on Washington in 1963. Daisy Gadsden Bates died in 1999 at the age of 84. Just days after her death, she was awarded the Congressional Gold Medal. And Arkansas continues to honor her. Schools and streets bear her name. And 2 years after her death, her home state named a state holiday in her honor, which is celebrated in conjunction with President's Day. Forgotten Voices is a celebration of Women's History Month.